Net positive suction head is one of the main considerations you make when selecting the appropriate pump for your system. Net positive suction head is the minimum pressure needed to prevent cavitation in a fluid. Cavitation is, well, that requires a little more explaining. Imagine you're standing in a swimming pool and you place your hand flat on the surface of the water, and then you push your hand down rapidly into the water. You should see trailing behind your hand in the water a stream of bubbles. The fact that your hand created a cavity in the water where air pockets were able to form is one definition of cavitation. Similar to the motion of your hand, the blades of the impeller of a pump are pushing on water constantly. On the trailing side of each impeller blade lies the potential for cavitation. This definition of cavitation by itself is not a problem for pumps. The problem starts as the next impeller blade, the one that's trailing the first, is catching the bubbles that are created. On the surface of the impeller blade, the bubbles can be compressed until the point of collapse. At the moment of collapse, a micro jet of water forms and strikes the surface of the impeller at a velocity greater than 100 meters per second. As you can imagine, this process, though happening on a micro level, can begin to pit the middle surface of the impeller blade. When you consider that these bubbles are forming and exploding at the rate of hundreds or thousands of mini explosions per second. Imagine again that you are standing in the pool, but this time you push your hand down with your you push down with your hand, starting several inches beneath the water surface rather than at the surface. You will see that not nearly as many bubbles are generated by the motion of your hand. This is due to the fact that the static pressure in the water keeps the water together and prevents the cavities from forming behind your hand. Therefore, in order to prevent the formation of bubbles in the first place, we must ensure that there is sufficient pressure head delivered to the fluid to prevent cavitation. In any given system, because the orientation of the reservoir to the pump or the diameter and roughness of the pipelines, there is a minimum net positive suction head available in the system. And this we simply abbreviate as NPSHA. It is calculated using the potential energy between the reservoir and the pump elevation. Written this way, you can see that if the pump is higher than the reservoir, then there is a negative potential energy that the pump must overcome, while if the pump is below the reservoir, then the potential energy is helping our NPSHA calculation. Next, we add in the effect of atmospheric pressure. This is a function of the elevation of the pump above sea level. We must also account for all friction and minor losses between the reservoir and the suction, pump suction. Finally, we must also account for the vapor pressure head of the fluid itself, which is a function of the temperature of the fluid. The difference in elevation between the reservoir and the pump is an engineering design choice we make, which also has an impact on the pipe diameter, length, and minor losses. We have tables that help us look up the atmospheric pressure as well as the vapor pressure as a function of water temperature. When we calculate the friction losses, we must use the Darcy-Weisbach head loss formula because, unlike the Hazen-Williams approach, the Darcy-Weisbach formula accounts for temperature variations in the fluid. It can also be applied to more fluids other than water, so if you're pumping oil, you can use Darcy-Weisbach. Every pump is tested by its manufacturer to assess the performance characteristics. One of the tests performed determines the net positive suction head required by the pump to avoid cavitation. So on the pump performance curve is often an additional line that represents how much NPSHR, as we call it, is needed at a given operating point. In theory, the NPSHA simply needs to be greater than or equal to the NPSHR. However, in practice, at least in water distribution systems, the NPSHA needs to be greater than the NPSHR by 5 feet. This additional head acts like a buffer against the uncertainties of pumping water. When we are pumping wastewater or sludge, the buffer we use is 7 feet. There are just greater number of uncertainties when pumping wastewater.